Well, hello. I pray that your Sunday is refreshing and that you're going to have a good night light. And I pray that you share this night light. My God, this morning I was awakened. Today is Saturday. I was awakened about 2 a.m. this morning. And as I began to look at the news, I began to just weep when I saw that so much is going on in the world today, and these poor babies are in so much distress and so much hurt and harm is coming to them. And just looking at the politics and things like that, you know, just praying for, saying, God, help me, why am I so wide awake? And then I saw about this pastor who I know you may have heard about it, who was actually, you know, publicly exposed about some type of oral sex or something he had done. And, you know, they call him the cussing preacher. But whatever, I just began to weep and say, God, help us. You know, Lord, what is going on? Lord, help us all. And as I began to reminisce and, you know, and just rest and pray, I thought about this subject for our message for today. And I pray that you would share this message. One of the things I find so interesting is that many of us don't realize that we are really, really, in this last day, especially those who are in leadership and those who are married, you know, and that have churches or ministries. And we won't get off the fact that we got to pay attention to those who are single, you know, and maybe struggling in their flesh. But we are in the what is called the Valley of Sorek, which is the valley, so that means the Valley of Seduction. And we've got to really be praying now, because these two spirits, Samson and Delilah, I wanted to kind of bring that out, because, you know, we're always talking about Delilah, but what about Samson? You know, I really wanted to talk about this because we're in a place right now, we got to understand that this Valley of Seduction has structures, and what its intention to do is to destroy. Now, when we talk about a structure, what I'm kind of going into when I'm talking about the deadly structure in this message, I'm talking about how Samson and Delilah has these death structures designed to destroy the marriage and the ministry and the churches, you know, and it's flowing through Samson, which we call the kings and all the priests of the house, and Delilah's, those who, these women that are very enticing, they don't even have to be single. I mean, these people are married even, you know, that are sleeping around or that are being very, very cunning and manipulative. But the Bible tells us, if we think about this message that I'm talking about today, when I'm talking about, you know, the Valley of Seduction, meaning, you know, the Valley of Sorek is where this Delilah woman came from. But we got to look at this seduction is one that is of our past, something that is old, something that we never died from, something that's constantly being enticing to us. This is the reason why so many leaders today who have fallen prey to sexual appetites and things like that are falling prey so easily, because they really have not died to their flesh. Now, I'm praying I can get through this message really quickly, but I want to get into talking about the structure, the deadly structure of a marriage or a ministry in the life of those that God has called to leadership, or those that God is trying to get the house in order so it'll be fitted together and strong to build strong families and children, so that they can just not hear us, but, you know, follow what God is showing us to build better families. So this word structure, what I'm getting at, if you think about the Latin word structurer, S-T-R-U-C-T-U-R-A, structurer, this means fitting, a fitting together, a building. So that means it can be more than that. That means it can be so structured that you can shape things into a certain way for it to function a certain way. I'm not going to have time to really go over what I really want to go over on this message, but when I think about the Samson and Delilah spirit, I think about what the Bible tells us over and over again in James 1, verses 13 through 15, when it says, when tempted, no one should say, God is tempting me. For God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he tempt anyone. But each one is tempted when, by his own evil desires, he's lured away and enticed. Then, after desire has been conceived, okay, this is why exposure comes. Many people have been exposed. Many people are, you know, I'm always saying that is let daddy deal with you in private through your repentance for real, so that he don't have to deal with you in public. But many people don't believe that. That's why we see so many who are still having sex with children and things like that, and think that, you know, I guess they got the perfect demonic plan that they think they'll never be exposed. But the Bible goes on to say in verse 15, then after desire has conceived, it gives birth to sin. And sin, when it is full, that's when we talk about the iniquity. When it's full grown, it gives birth to death. Now, when I'm talking about this Delilah and Samson type of mentality, many of us don't realize that we have been enticed by our old man. You know, I can remember, as I get into what I mean by enticed, this word, I can remember when I was just fixed to get married. I won't ever forget that. You know, it was like, okay, I'm called to ministry. Here I am. I'm getting ready to evangelize. Now everybody's got their attention on what I'm trying to do to build better families, to try to break the cycle of, you know, violence in homes, and to be better. Well, right when I got ready to get married, now I've already been with this man now 6 years living together, shacking up. I know I'm talking to somebody. But when I made a decision I was going to get married, here comes Samson. Now, he wasn't a man of leadership, but he's supposed to be a man that loved God, and he was married. I know I'm talking to somebody. And he was married, and so I decided that I'm going to go ahead on and let him lure me. This enticement means to, you know, persuade me. He persuaded me to meet him at the motel on our lunch break. He worked, and I worked, of course. And he persuaded me to meet him at the motel. And then I said, well, one time won't hurt, you know, especially he was just so fine. You know, so I said, well, you know, he's just giving me all these roses and buttering me up and making me feel, you know, just so beautiful. And I figured, okay, well, my man that I've been living with 6 years, he's not giving me that kind of attention, but he says he wants to marry me. I got this beautiful ring. So I figured, okay, let me go ahead and marry him. Been living with him 6 years already, so we might as well do the right thing. So I'm trying to do the right thing. At the same time, the old man, I don't want to preach, the old man is coming back talking to me about, you need to go on and try this one more time, at least to see really if you really want to be married. You know, you really know that this is what you like. You know, let's just try this with this guy. You know, so he persuades me. That's what that enticement does. He makes these promises that he's going to leave his wife and that we're going to be together because he knows that I'm supposed to marry him and not the man that I've been with these 6 years. I don't want to preach. But anyway, this word enticed means to lure or to tempt someone by promising them something that they like. You know, that I'm going to get you all these things that you desire, Sandy. Please marry me. You know, and bringing me all these flowers, bringing me, you know, giving me money and telling me things, you know, just tell your fiance that, you know, that these are your secret pal gifts, you know, or whatever. But what this is a slick. And see, that's what Delilah is. It's a slick. It's a smooth talk. It's a slow manipulation. I don't want to preach. What it does in the very shape that this man, they call it a cussing preacher, you know, he wasn't enticed. It is a spirit that it was upon him that is in this last day that was already a structure that he was already entangled with. And that's what the Bible tells us. This is the reason why we got weak churches today. This is why we got weak marriages today, because they're too entangled with the world. I don't want to preach. Anyway, 2 Timothy 2 and 4 tells us, no man that warreth entangled himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier, not to be somebody who want to go around and entangle himself with lust desires and get snared with these Delilah mentalities. These women got all these two little pour-on dresses and all short, right sitting in the front of the preacher while he's trying to preach, and the first lady over there fanning herself and trying to keep from jab-slapping her, that you got your legs wide open while my husband's trying to talk, you know, and that you got this two little dress on that you want to sit all up front. I don't want to talk. I don't want to preach. But I've witnessed this thing, this entanglement that we have allowed to come in the church, that we've allowed to even entangle ourselves with because of the smooth talk, because of our fleshly thoughts, you know, that we got all these complicated snares that's trying to get us to get involved and be confused and be intrigued by this stuff. So our brain becomes so clouded and entrapped, you know, and twisted with these things that make us feel like, oh, it's just too perplexed. You know, it's just too many decisions I have to make. And, you know, the devil wants you to believe that you all, you know, got these entangles of confusion. And all the time, there ain't nothing but lust. You know, just simply what it is. Lord, I want to preach. I ain't got but 2 minutes left. Let's see if I can do it, Donna. I don't know. Because I want to make sure you understand where I'm coming from. You got to share this message. And we got to begin to pray. You know, we see all the things even with the president. These things that we say, oh, they need to impeach him. We see all this stuff. But in this last day, we got to know that Daddy God wants to use all this hell so that, as I just said, so that as we begin so tempted and all these evil things and things that we think that we're going to be all these gods on our own to get entangled in these structures, yeah, this hell is going to keep on going until the iniquity is full grown. Yeah, come on. And after it's full grown, pop, there it is. And so we don't know which way Daddy going to do with the president. We don't know which way Daddy going to do with these that's running through these official, elected offices now. Office of election now, and we don't know what that is going to do as it continues to expose this hell, this lust, these Samson, these Delilah destructive structures that are in the ministries, in marriages, and you know, we don't want to leave out in these ways that we've seen, and we believe that it's going to be all right, that Daddy God ain't going to do nothing. Now, if you go back and look at Judges chapter 16, verse 4, it talks about it came to pass afterward that Samson, who really was raised to do the right thing, you know, and he wanted to love this woman. He wanted to be with this woman from the valley of Sorek, whose name was Delilah. Now, when we think about it, these structures that I was talking about a few minutes ago, they're all coming from the simple idea that we just want what we want when we want, and that's what Samson wanted. Samson did all this, how they say, mighty works, you know, to help bring Israel out. But he wanted to do all these things that were so unclean, even though he did all this supernatural empowerment for Israel. You know, Samson had this weakness like a whole lot of these men and women have today. They just want to be touched. They want to be loved. They just want to be, you know, how they say, knowing that I still got it going on, or that these men who are married just want to see whether or not I still can make a woman turn her eyes to me, you know, pumping iron all the time, or, you know, confusing their identity of sex, and so they want to wear the clothes that are clinging to show their bodies. I don't want to preach, but here's my time right now. I got to get off of here. But I'm very, very moved by how Samson desired and was urgent and you know, just pressing for them to get that woman Delilah to him. Why? He kept saying in Judges 14:3, because she pleases me. Why? His eyes were deceived. His structure was crooked. It was bent. He married this woman who betrayed him and nearly, how they say, almost destroyed everybody, but he wound up getting so entangled with this harlot, he wound up dying. See, what happens is that we got these evil eyes that we think is going to be okay for us, and that everything that we desire, everything that we think is going to give us what we need in the natural realm, in the physical realm of our bodies, is going to give us what we need. Delilah and Samson are great examples. This word enticement means that she wanted to lead. She wanted to lead them, lead him, that is, in this exciting way, to show him that she can get him and do things for him in this slow, manipulative way. She didn't rush it. She did it real slow and slick. And this is what's going on today in the body, slow and slick. And so she says, see wherein this is your great strength. Tell me about it. Where does it lie? And the same thing. You know, they're telling us these things to make us believe that this is okay for me to be in the room with you and you counsel me and that I hug you a certain way. The next thing you know, they got the tongue down the throat. We got to make sure we understand what structures we're building inside the church and in relationships that we know that it's not godly. We need to think about how can we prevail against these things that's causing us to prove something that we know that we're not. You know, to prove the strength of this power. Some are abusing power. Some are taking power to manipulate. Some are taking power to be able to overpower those who are weak. I don't want to preach. But one of the things about these types of spirits, they like to bind people in positions. And these definitions, as far as this binding word and this word that I was talking about right now, structure, this binding structure, what it is designed to do, to imprison the person in their mind, to make them feel something that's really not of God. They want to afflict them spiritually by oppressing them, making them humble themselves, for them to bow down, to come in agreement with this type of mentality, to be very, very manipulative so they can move and do what they want to do with you. But I want you to know right now, one of the things that we got to realize that these dainties of Delilah, these dainties of Samson, the mentalities, this Delilah, this perverted mentality, these passions that we seem like they just cannot control, they tend to be so perverted that they don't even realize that they're perverted. And that's the reason why that the Lord is allowing them to be exposed publicly, because he's been trying to get them to repent privately. We got to make sure you understand that Daddy God is watching. He can see all. One of the things God also wants to realize is he wants to focus on the things that are still, how they say, giving us this worldly desire of the flesh, these things that we want to look so blessed and highly favored about, that manipulative type of cunning mentality, make it look like if you don't have this or if you don't get with me, you're going to lose this, or if you leave me, you're going to leave your position, First Lady. You're not going to have this nice house. So you just deal with the Samson mentality and the Delilah dainties. I don't want to preach, Lord help, right in the midst of a church. But here I am trying to get you to see Delilah destroys Samson's destiny. And this is where we are. These death structures are there in marriages. These death structures are there when we have these ministries who are not listening to what God is saying to them about the perversion, about the passions, to be redirected away from these worldly pleasures. But we continue to listen to the lust of the flesh and the seductions from the valley of Sorek. And so these maneuvers of Delilah, these maneuvers of Samson, they continue to have us wallow in the mud of destruction. And we find ourselves having new structures that are there to have us thinking that we're so slick, we're so smooth, we're so beautiful, we're so handsome, and that we have the best sex, we've got all the things we need to look so blessed and highly favored. And then as the Bible tells in James chapter 1, verse 13, that is verse 14, but each one is tempted, and when by his own evil desires, he's lured away and enticed. And guess what? He is destructive. He is being destroyed by his own enticements and its own lust. I pray that you pay attention to these Samson Delilah death structures that may be in your life, or even in your relationship with your church, and even in your own marriage. I want to take just a minute, because I didn't want to stay on here long, but it was so moving me today. We got a lot of power plays here today. We got a lot of people who are playing a lot of games and got a lot of mindsets to believe that they can be their own gods and their own leaders, and that they can do what they want to do, and they're wondering why things are not growing. They're wondering why things are weakening. They're wondering why churches are emptying out. They're wondering why things are being exposed within the body of Christ. And that is because Daddy is tired trying to give us a chance to repent it all in private before he exposes us publicly. I thank God for deliverance from myself being there in that position with a married man and repented for myself and for him. And did I go forward with him? No, I did not. I repented and ran out of that hotel, told him, please let me out of here. I'll pay you back your money, but I am not going to do this. We have too much, easy way out to go ahead and get it done and get it over with, but yet we suffer in the long run. And so let us pray about this fear now of death structures that is in the body, in the marriages today, in the ministries, in regard to Samson and Delilah, these death structures that are there to bring the valley of seduction and destruction. So, Father, I pray that one is listening to me even now in the name of Jesus. I pray, God, that you would touch them, Father, and that you would strengthen them, and they would understand and realize they got to make sure that what they're feeling is nothing but lust, and what they're thinking and what their eyes are gazing upon is nothing but lust, and that their ultimate enticement, their ultimate, Lord God, temptation is going to destroy them. So, Lord, I pray that they will quickly repent, and that to realize that you will quickly forgive, and that they what they know and will react to is that they, when they repent, they will know that they cannot turn back to the vomit. I pray, God, in Jesus' name, that you restore every marriage and every ministry. I pray, God, that those that even now that know situations concerning those who are naked and they think that they're covered, that they will begin to pray for them, Father. They will pray for these leaders, that they'll pray for those who have fallen. I pray that their eyes will have an enlightenment to understand the suffering that they are not only doing to themselves, but that they're doing to others. I pray, God, that they would ask for this forgiveness, and that they realize this stronghold can be destroyed, that you will tear it down every stronghold that you would tear it down, and that you would show your divine power in the name of Jesus. I pray, God, that in every area of their lives, that these seducing spirits of Delilah, Lord God, these seducing spirits of Samson, Father, that even now every thought and every action, every deed, God, that you'll begin now to touch that family, touch that ministry, touch that leader, God, that these places, Father, are death destruction, Father, that these death structures, Father, that they'll begin to be exposed and destroyed now in the name of Jesus. I repent, Father, for anyone that I know and any leader, God, that is in my circle, even now, I pray for them, Father. I pray, God, that they'll have right decisions, Father, they'll follow their heart, Lord God, of you, Father. And I pray, God, that they'll realize that if they repent, God, in these areas of their lives, that you'll come in agreement with them, Father, and that the acts of Satan and the deeds, God, that they've done through the mind of Satan, God, these seductions will be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray, God, that every underlying thing, God, that's slick and that's smooth talk, God, those things that they see with their eyes, God, even now I pray for deliverance. I pray for the breakthrough. I pray for even divine healing from hurts and disappointment and betrayal and lust, God. I pray that every soul tie that they may be entangled with even now, God, unfaithful vows, God, that's been broken, Father. I pray for these marriages, and I decree and I declare today, God, that they're being empowered and being fulfilled for your glory, for the righteous covenant, Father, for their lives and their marriage. I thank you, Lord, that they're being set free even now by the power of your blood and your cross even now, God. I pray and I stand the gap even now for these marriages and these ministries, Father. I plead the blood of Jesus even now. Come on, repeat it after me. Even now, I recover all. Even now, I recover all. I thank you, Father. Even now, in no other name but Jesus, we decree to you that you have given them the strength to recover all from every enticing, every death structure, everything that's caused this family, this ministry, or, Lord God, that leader, Father, that marriage to become destroyed from Samson and Delilah death structures. We thank you and we give you all the praise and all the honor and all the glory in Jesus' name. I pray you share this message. God bless you so much. I pray your week will be wonderful. And I pray you will say like what I just said. Say like, think about it, okay? Think about who you can get to understand that these are death structures for the marriage and the ministry, you know, for the leadership. Come on now. We've got to recognize these Delilah and Samson spirits are real, and they are not playing with the very, very elect. Even today, we have got to fight. We've got to contend for the faith. Love you so much. God bless you.